Now, once it's powered up, we see the smart home demo application that we have prepared for the for the purpose, just to show the performance of a display and what we can do. Of course, the touch will be also working, so I can maybe switch on or check some camera. Hello, my name is Kamil. I'm CEO and founder of Riverdi. Today, I would like to present to you our second product from the latest line that we have, which is STM32 Embedded Display line. So the line that is including microcontroller, memory, and everything that is needed to run. So the entire system actually is attached on the display. So we have an HMI that includes not only the hardware, but also the software from fantastic TouchGFX team and library. Okay, so what I have here is a 7-inch. So first one that we introduced was a 10.1-inch. You can find the link to the video about 10.1-inch in the link below. Actually, the 10.1-inch is a high-resolution display run by STM32H7 microcontroller. This one, because it's 7-inch, is a little bit smaller, has a bit lower resolution, which is 1024 by 600, but still it's a high resolution display comparing to the size of a 7-inch, made on IPS technology. Of course, everything is industrial here because we talk about a Riverdi display. So let's see what is in the box and what you will have when you will buy. When you will buy a sample of this display, it will not be a bulk package. It will be a single package like the one I have here. So it will be just one box and one display inside. So let's have a look what we have. First, we will see in the box package with the cables. And we have two cables here. I will explain them right now. So same as before with the 10-inch, we will get the power cable. This one is a 6-pin Molex connector. Right now we use a 6-pin. Before previous, let's say, models, they were 5-pin. So please make sure you have the correct cable, but of course it will be packed together. So right now, the latest one is 6-pin Molex cable like this. And it has two Molex connectors on both sides. So probably you will need to cut one of the connectors and connect it to your power supply. Actually, I have it done here. So I have this Molex connector, I cut it and I connected it to the standard power supply jack connector that I will use to power up the display. But in the box, you will find a cable like this. Please make sure to connect and use the right wires and pins for the power, because we have a 6-pin here. There are power lines, but there is also an enable pin. Please do not suggest yourself by the colors of the cable. You may get a colorful cable like this one or the all black cables. And the colors are not suggesting the, let's say, polarity or anything like that. Please make sure to connect it according to the data sheet. There is a pinout of the power connector. And the second cable that we have in the box that is very useful is a programming cable. Yes, so from on one side we have the Molex connector that is on the board, and on the other side we have very standard connector for ST-Link programmer for version 2, version 3 as well. You will find this very popular programmer for ST microcontrollers. So having this cable and the power cable, actually you are able to unbox the display and start programming. Okay, so let's see what's inside more. Of course, we should find a display there, which is good protected. Okay, so what we have here, of course, is a display like this. This model is actually 7-inch UX Touch, so that means with the power, with the touch screen that is a little bit bigger than the display itself, and this one is optically bonded. It's the highest, let's say, a quality version, the highest possible model of this display, and of course it's recommended for most of the application. It can be used indoor and outdoor because it's a high brightness. And of course on the back we have the board with all the components. We have explained this in other videos what we have on the board, but you can see this on the website very clear as well and in the data sheet. Basically we have used everything that this microcontroller offer including all the peripherals, so all the pins are used, and what was left we put on the extension connector. So actually you can extend the functionality of this display, adding your own extension boards, maybe using a Wi-Fi or something like that. But basically we have all the connectivity here already. So we have RS232, we have RS485, we have double CAN buses, which are very popular right now. We have USB, we have SD card, despite the 64 megabyte memory, flash memory on the board already. We have extension for the Ethernet board, and actually this Ethernet board will have two versions, will be the regular, just Ethernet, and then you need to power the display with the power connector, but there will be also the PoE version, yes, so power over Ethernet, so everything will be able to be powered just from the Ethernet cable as well, and these boards will be shortly available from our website. Okay, so let's try this display, let's power it on. It's already programmed by factory, so when we are manufacturing the display, of course we are testing it, so we are programming it with the demo application based on the TouchGFX. Yes, so now I will connect this power cable to the display and to the power connector, and let's see what we will have once we power up the display. Yes, so now once it's powered up, we see the smart home demo application that we have prepared for the for the purpose, just to show the performance of a display and what we can do. Of course the touch will be also working, so I can maybe switch on or check some camera on the screen. So this demo is just to show you that everything is working as it should be. Pretty much it. I can change the temperature or whatever, switch on some lights. So this is the demo application like that. So that's all in this video. I hope you like it, and this is informative. So what you will get from our box when you will buy a sample of this display, you can buy it directly from our website, but you can also buy it from our distribution network, from catalog distributor or project distributors that we have worldwide. And I hope you will enjoy working with this display, because the hardware is just the half of the story here. The other half, of course, is a TouchGFX library that is ready to be downloaded, and you will find in the TouchGFX library our display there, so to be pre-configured. Yes, so you don't need to do any low-level configuration. Everything is there. You can start just with the high-level programming. Actually, TouchGFX is built in a way that you can make your own graphic applications in a way that is like drag and drop. Yes, so what you see is what you get. You build your layers, graphic layers in the application very easy, like you do on the PC, and then just click run on the target and program the target, and everything goes to the microcontroller and is being run on this embedded system. Well, thank you for watching this video. Please remember to subscribe to our channel to get access to more videos like that and more informative about display and touch technologies. Please click the like button. It's helping YouTube algorithm to find our video, and I really hope to see you with our next video.
Want to learn more about Riverdi products? Please visit our page riverdi.com. Feel free to contact us if you have any questions. Our team is always there to help and guide you. And please remember to subscribe Riverdi YouTube channel. See you later in our next video.